on the next chapter. Hips like Shakira, but she an actor. It's just a factor, she's full of beautiful lads. Man, she's just a capper. She played in my heart, then guess what she said? Beyond me, you got a great future ahead. Then left me on bread. Fuck these hoes, said a lot for the family instead. Stick to my family, stick to my team. Seen a bad shit, you'll see in your dreams. I'ma be on top with a high esteem. Gotta stay humble when I fuck up the scene. Supreme, McQueen's materialistic, things I don't need. Not the kind of guy to chain for the peas. Hate said it's in the track, he's not in the jeans. The sun goes down, my zoo comes up. Smoke a 3-5, but it still ain't enough. My mind is fucked, it will never be the same. I'm glad you came, I'm glad you came.
I'm glad you came, shawty. About time you stayed for me. Outside we're loose, we give them chills. We ain't the same, buddy. Cold when the sun goes down, I hit my blunt. I'm glad you came, bet you glad I'm paid. Or is it fame? Why you owed us? Is she really down for us? Tell me, would you stay? Can't make her stay. If she can't keep it real, for the real, and for real.
The sun goes down, my zoo comes up. Smoke a 3-5, but it still ain't enough. My mind is fucked, it will never be the same. I'm glad you came, I'm glad you came.
This is the last time you're going to be here with me on this particular occasion for Prime Minister's Questions after your tenure as political editor of the BBC. And, of course, we've loved having you here. It's been nearly 7 years. I can't quite believe that long. And so much has happened in that time. I mean, I don't know if we can rewind briefly changing political landscape.
Well, the week after I started the show, or about a fortnight after I began, Jeremy Corbyn won the Labour leadership for the first time, which sort of delighted a huge number of people who came into the Labour movement, appalled quite a lot of people in the Labour establishment, certainly surprised a lot of them at what happened.
Where were you, Andrew, in that? Appalled, surprised, or
quite a lot of people in the middle have tried to make the best of it,
I think.
Then, of course, the year after we had the referendum, which again completely upset the political establishment, who hadn't seen what was coming, even though if you were outside the Westminster bubble, it was quite obvious the enthusiasm was absolutely going the other way almost from the beginning of the campaign. Then, the year after that, we had a general election. Then we had this sort of Brexit agonies with Theresa May trying to keep control of everything, but it was, you know, chaotic. And night after night after night, people kind of screaming at each other about
fought
Brexit.
Fought out in this studio, constantly.
Yeah, fought out in this studio. And also, you know, on College Green, which for viewers who haven't been to Westminster, is the sort of park between where we sit here today and Parliament. Day after day, that was crammed with protesters from both sides screaming at each other, screaming at us, screaming at you, no doubt, as people were trying to make things work. And then Theresa May was eventually forced out. Then we had another general election.
I'm exhausted
Boris
already.
Boris Johnson, yes, I'm a bit tired after all of that. And then, of course, as soon as Boris Johnson's massive majority was secure, he was, you know, at last in his achieving his ambition of seeming like king of the world, then the pandemic came in.
Within 3 months.
Within 3 months.
And he himself,
the country
of course,
down,
was
for nearly 2 years. And then, of course, now, as we've just been talking about, you know, war on continental Europe, which is something that way back in 2015, no one would have contemplated, even looking at what happened in 2014 and what Vladimir Putin had been done then. So I suppose the beginning, a more benign time, and then a lot of chaos, a lot of turmoil. But I also think an era, actually, when people have really
engaged
into politics.
In a way. I know lots of people said it turned them off all the Brexit debate, but I think a lot of people did actually switch on to politics in terms of the
because
debate.
Because we've all been arguing, you guys have been arguing over massive questions of identity, questions about Britain's place in the world. And also we've had, you know, people who like to style themselves as being on the outside of the political debate prospering. So whether that was Jeremy Corbyn or, you know, Boris Johnson, who, you know, claims somehow he's anti-elite, but that whole narrative around Brexit, the sort of trying to topple the elites.
And also there was a sort of shaking of the foundations
completely.
Of left and right and, you know, what described Conservative and Labour.
That's right. You know, the Tory party has been in power that whole time. But my goodness, it's a very different Conservative Party. So much has happened. And the biggest thing probably is we're all wandering around with these things and technology has changed how politics
never away from our ears. I'm not
so
going to ask
much.
For any forecasts because I think that's a
hostage
to
fall. I gave up on them a long time ago.
Thank you very much to our guests. That's all we have time for. Bye-bye.